Hey everyone, what's going on? In today's video, we're going to go into step-by-step guide on how to use CBO campaigns for Facebook ads in 2019. Let's go. All right, step one, we're going to duplicate our best ad sets into a new campaign. So when you start out, if you have ad sets that are already running, you're just going to duplicate them into a new campaign and you're going to change it to campaign-based optimization. If you don't have any ad sets and you want to start out with a CBO, then you're just going to make it in a CBO. I'm going to show you both ways right now. All right, lovely. So I have this draft campaign here, okay, with an ad set in it. All you do is you duplicate it, new campaign. I like to call it CBO-dog collar, okay? That's just what I like to do, and we'll go duplicate. Okay, and bam, we have now made our new ad set. And then we just go edit, and we change it to on, okay? If you don't have one like that straight away, it's even easier actually. Mainly the reason that you would duplicate an ad set, and that is to keep the post ID, unless you have the post ID written down somewhere. Either way, that's just the way I do it. From the beginning like this, you just go conversions. We just want to turn on the dial. I recommend a day, $50 a day, if you can spend that. And again, I just name it CBO dog collar V2, let's say. And then you go through the next steps, okay? It's as simple as that. That's how you start getting a CBO campaign set up. Let's move into the next. Step number two, set and define the budget. So I touched on this just a moment ago. But CBO campaigns, you want the lowest cost. So there's different types of bidding strategies, okay? I haven't found manual bidding makes much of a difference. I prefer to do that on the ad set level. For CBO campaigns to work, you set it based off the amount of ad sets you have each. So example, again, if you have 10 ad sets in there, and let's say hypothetically that you're running them individually at $5, you would set it $50. If you have five, you have 25. Okay, I don't recommend a CBO campaign below $10 at minimum. Optimally is $50, but anywhere in between that will work as well. So I'm just gonna show you again just how you do it. All right, fabulous. So with this, all you do is you edit at the campaign level in the campaign tab. You change it, you can change it to lifetime budget. I don't use lifetime budgets. But you just change it there and it's going to apply that across all ad sets. See how we've also got lowest cost? You can have bid cap and target cost. Different bidding strategies, not relevant. You just want lowest cost, okay? So that explains step two. Let's move. Step number three, duplicate the CBO campaign. Okay, so you duplicate the campaign twice without changing any details. Okay, so what I have found is that campaign-based optimizations do well. Some do well and some do bad. It's the exact same with ad sets. Okay, and so after 24 hours maximum, you're just going to kill the ones that aren't profitable. Okay, so I want you to understand that if you had $50 budgets on a CBO, you're going to be duplicating it twice. You're actually spending $150, and all of those ad sets are going to be spending differently. You're going to find one of those campaigns will be doing really well, and that's the one that you can scale. Okay, I've just found that is the way, because Facebook is all about duplication. So I'm just going to show you how to do that right now. All right, fabulous. So back in here, all we do is we've now defined our budget. We've defined everything we need. We just duplicate it. We go twice and we've now duplicated it and we schedule it for midnight. I always suggest starting your CBO campaigns at midnight. Change nothing. Okay. Let Facebook do the work. After 24 hours, you're going to have a clear defined winner. Okay. And this definitely works best when you have consistent sales coming in, I should add as well. Basically, the reason this works well is it's the exact same as my duplication of ad sets level, except now you're going a step back and you're doing it at the campaign level. And what you're going to do is that the whole campaign is going to be a profitable campaign, which you can scale quite high. Step number four, optimization. So although we are using a campaign-based optimization campaign strategy, we should always be optimizing ad sets. So you want to split test the various demographics. I've gone through that in other videos. I suggest you go watching that. If you've hit the maximum amount of ad sets in a CBO campaign, make another with them duplicated in there. So little tip, CBO campaigns, I believe, have only 70 ad sets they can have within it. It doesn't let you actually make any more, regardless of if they're enabled or disabled. Okay, and the goal with this is to use CBO to manage the budget. And what we're doing is we're trimming the fat all at the same time. So this allows us to scale a CBO campaign that has all the demographics that aren't doing well, that are doing best, quite profitably. You're doing two things at the same time. So I'm just going to show you how this works now. All right, fabulous. So with my campaigns that I've made here, all I do is I go into here and I want to optimize this. Okay, so if I want to optimize it, generally how I would do it, because I go 25 and up, if I got an ad set that's doing well, I'll split test all of them. And basically it's as simple as this. So, all right. So if I go 25, so this is, sorry, how I do it. All right, cool. So 25, 34, 35, 44, 45, 54, 55, 64. I hate doing this. 65 plus. Okay. And then this is how easy it is. You can just do it in here. I've done this 1,000 times. So, and basically you just set up your ad sets that way. This is the best way to do it because we're split testing now within a CBO campaign. And that way we're seeing, you know, what demographics does well, what demographics don't do well at the same time. And we're killing the bad ones. Okay. And so by killing the bad ones, we all of a sudden are able to make an even more profitable campaign and just keep doing that. Okay. And as I said, little tip, if you run out of ad sets, make another campaign. I just put the word dash optimized on the end, dashed optimized two, dashed optimized three, because the goal is to continue optimizing across the board. Because, you know, once you find some really good demographics, it makes quite a difference. So you can see here that I've now made it. We schedule it for midnight. We just choose, you know, in your time zone, I just choose that and then you're good to go. Step six, increasing the budget. So after 48 hours, if it's profitable, increase the budget, okay, by double. I find that CBO, you can comfortably do this. So literally, if you're on 25, go 50, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, you can even make automated rules for it, okay? But as a little tip here, the reason that I say 48 hours and not 24 hours is simply because of the fact if you have 10 ad sets, what's going to happen is a number of those ad sets are going to spend, a number of them aren't. So you want to give it 48 hours to really define. You're going to trim the fat during that time anyway, but you want to give it 48 hours to really define that, okay? All right, so again, basically just when you, whatever budget you're on, you just change it from 20 to 40, 40 to 80, it doesn't matter. And you do it in 48 hour increments is sort of what I've done. And I find it works quite well. And in that time, I'm optimizing ad sets, killing the bad ones, and you just keep cycling through that. I must admit that I find this is a very effective way. I really love how I don't have to now set individual budgets. I love how I can just set it overall. I just launch my ads. Okay, now I always recommend as well, lastly, to still set your ads that you're optimizing to midnight. Okay, just give it, wait until midnight, still do it that way. And that concludes today's video on how to run CBO campaigns, campaign-based optimization for Facebook ads in 2019. If you did like today's video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification down below. And comment crush it down below as well to go on the chance to win one of two 15-minute coaching calls with myself, Ricky Hayes. It's been a lot of fun teaching you that today. Have a lovely day. Take care and goodbye.